Today I am going to present what is suspension bridge and 3-inch stepping girder and how to do the analysis of suspension bridge with 3-inch stepping girder subjected to the external loading. Here we will discuss all the analysis, that is the analysis of suspension bridge and 3-inch stepping girder by solving a problem. Already we have discussed in previous class that what is cable and suspension bridge. So here we will discuss about the 3-inch stepping girder. You know, since the cable of the suspension bridge is the main load bearing member, the curvature of the cable of an unstepped bridge changes as the load moves on the deck. You see, in the suspension bridge, the cable is the main load bearing member. So when the load moves along the suspension bridge, so what will happen? The curvature of the cable of an unstepped bridge changes as the load moves on the decking. As the load moves on the decking, the curvature of the cable of an unstepped bridge changes. But to avoid this change of curvature, the decking is stiffened by either a 3-inch stiffening girder or a 2-inch stiffening girder. So you can avoid this change of curvature of the cable in unstiffened bridge. What you have to do? So you have to do the decking is stiffened by either 3-inch stiffening girder or 2-inch stiffening girder. What is 3-inch stiffening girder and what is 2-inch stiffening girder? So in the case of 3-inch stiffening girder, there are 3 hinges present. So 2 hinges are the two support, that is are the abutment, and the third hinge is present at the center of the stepping girder. But in the case of 2-inch stepping girder, only 2 hinges is present at the support, that is at the abutment, only 2 hinges is present in the case of 2-inch stepping girder. The stepping girder transfers a uniform or equal load to each suspender irrespective of the position of the load on the decking. Figure 1 shows a suspension bridge with a stepping girder hinged at the abutment A dash, B dash, and also at the center C dash. So coming to this one, look at this figure. So this is the typical suspension bridge with 3-inch stepping girder. So this is the cable, this is the suspension cable, and these are the suspenders. These are the suspenders, the vertical line, these are the suspender, and this is the stepping girder. This is your called the stepping girder, this one. The bottom of this one is the stepping girder. So here you see, there are 3 hinges present. So two are the abutment, this is the abutment. This is A dash and B dash, this is the abutment, and the suspension with 3-inch stepping girder is resting on the abutment. So here this is the stepping girder, 3-inch stepping girder. So here present 2 hinges at 2 ends, that is on the abutment. Third hinge is present at the center of the girder. These are the external loading present on the girder. This is the AP, this is AP, this is the suspension cable, and this is the length of the cable, and this is the center point of the cable. C is the center point of the cable, and C dash is the center point of the girder. So what you have to do here? Here you have to do the analysis of the 3-inch stepping girder and the suspension cable, because this is the suspender. So due to this suspender, the load is exerted, that is the uniform distributed load on the girder and on the cable. So by considering this uniform distributed load and the external loading, so you have to analyze the 3-inch stepping girder, and by considering the uniform distributed load from the suspender, and by considering that uniform distributed load, you have to do the analysis of the suspension cable. three inch tympani girder has three hinges, two are the ends and one are the center. Truss or heavy beam can be used for the tympani girder. So this is the tympani girder. So you can use truss or heavy beam for the tympani girder. The cable and the girder are connected by a number of hangers or suspenders. This is the cable and this is the girder. So both are connected by a number of suspender. Cable and the girder, both are connected by a number of suspenders. As the number of suspenders are very large and due to the forces in the suspenders, the load of the cable or girder may be taken as uniformly distributed load. Due to the number of suspenders, what you have to do? So the load you have to take as a uniformly distributed load on the 3-inch tympani girder and on the cable. As the number of suspenders are very large and due to the forces in the suspender, the load on the cable or girder may be taken as uniformly distributed load. So look at this figure. This is the free body diagram of cable and girder. So this is the free body diagram of the cable and this is the free body diagram of the 3-inch tympani girder. This is 3-inch tympani girder. And what are the forces acting on the 3-inch tympani girder? So this is the figure. And here also, what are the forces acting on the cable? This is the figure. So this is the free body diagram of suspension cable and 3-inch tympani girder. So here you see, this is the suspenders. So due to suspender, the load is exerted on the cable and on the girder. This load is you have to take as a uniformly distributed load. The load exerted on the girder or on the suspension cable from the suspender, that is the uniform distributed load and that is acting per unit length. The load is acting W per unit length. You have to do the analysis of 3-inch tympani girder and also you have to do the analysis of the suspension cable. In the case of 3-inch tympani girder, so this is the uniform distributed load. This is your acting upward direction. And due to this uniform distributed load, the reaction is your in the downward direction. Here you see, this is the uniform distributed load. This is acting WE per unit length. WE per unit length. So what is the reaction at the end A dash and B dash? So what is the reaction due to the uniform distributed load? So here you see, this is the WE per unit length. This is the uniform distributed load acting on the 3-inch tympani girder. So the length of the girder is small l. So what is the total load is acting on the 3-inch tympani girder? WE into L. What is the reaction at both end of the 3-inch tympani girder? This is WEL by 2 and here also WEL by 2. So this is the reaction at both end due to the uniform distributed load. Due to uniform distributed load on the tympani girder, so this is the reaction WEL by 2 and here WEL by 2. These are the load acting on the tympani girder. So due to this load, so this is the reaction because this load is your acting, this is the external load is acting. So here the external load is acting W1, W2 and W3. And due to these three external load, what is the reaction at both end of the tympani girder? This is RA dash and RB dash. You have to take reaction due to the external loading. This is RA dash at end A and RB dash at end B. So you can find out due to the external loading, what is the reaction at both end A dash and B dash. And due to the uniform distributed load, what is the reaction at both end? That also you can find out. So this is the total the forces acting on the 3-inch tympani girder. Similarly, in the cable, so this is the uniform distributed load. This is the uniform distributed load is acting on the suspension cable. So due to this uniform distributed load, so what is the reaction at the both end A and B? Due to this uniform distributed load, what is the reaction at both end of the cable? So at A, the reaction you take VA, this is your equal to WEL by 2 because this is the load W per unit length. And what is the total length? W into L. And what is the reaction at A? WEL by 2. And that reaction at B, VB is equal to WEL by 2. So reaction at both end of the suspension cable, so that is your equal to WEL by 2. This is the reaction due to the uniform distributed load. Let the uniform distributed load is equal to W per unit horizontal length. Let C dash is the central hinge of the girder. Already I have discussed this one. Let C dash is the central hinge of the girder. Let the uniformly distributed load W exerted by suspender on the girder. So this is the load exerted by suspender on the girder, W per unit length. So the beam may be analyzed for the given load along with W. So you have to do the analysis due to the external loading and due to the uniform distributed load. Already I have discussed. So due to the uniform distributed load, this is the reaction, and due to the external loading, the reaction at the end is your RA dash and RB dash. So first you take due to the uniform distributed load along. So what is the bending moment at section XX? So let us take one section at a distance X from the end B, from the support B. So this is the section. So what is the moment of the section? What is the moment of the section? Here you see, first to take the moment due to the uniform distributed load. Uniform distributed load, what is acting on the 3-inch stiffening girder? So this is the reaction due to the uniform distributed load. This is the load. So what is the moment of the section? Due to this reaction, so what is the moment here? Minus W E L by 2 into X. So when you are taking the moment about this section of this reaction, W L by 2 into X. And due to this load, and this is your clockwise moment, so you have to take this is negative, and this is your anti-clockwise moment due to this UTL, this is anti-clockwise moment, and you have to take this is positive. And due to this UTL, what is the moment? W into X into X by 2. So here the moment, bending moment at section XX is equal to minus WLX by 2 plus WX square by 2. So this is equal to minus WX by 2 into L minus X. Then what is the maximum bending moment at C? What is the maximum bending moment you will get at C? Due to the uniform distributed load, what is the maximum bending moment you will get at the center of the 3-inch stiffening girder? So here you see, this is WEL by 2. And what is the length? What is the length of this one? L by 2. And due to this UTL, WE L by 2. And what is the CG distance? L by 4. WE L by 2 into L by 2. The maximum bending moment at C is equal to minus WE L by 2 into L by 2 plus WE L by 2 into L by 4. So this is equal to minus WE L square by 8. So the maximum bending moment at the C, the maximum bending moment at C is equal to WE L square by 8. And this is a hugging bending moment. This is a hugging moment. Because you got here the negative moment, means this is the hugging moment. Because here, so this is the bending takes place this manner. This is the hugging. This is this manner the bending takes place. Because this is at the end, this is the downward direction, and this is the upward direction. So here the hugging moment takes place due to the UTL on the stiffening girder. So the maximum bending moment at C is equal to WE L square by 8 hugging moment. What is the shear force at section XX? So what is the shear force here? So due to this one, WE L by 2, and due to this UTL, what is the shear force? W into X. So WE L by 2 minus WX. WE L by 2 minus WX. Here this is downward, take positive, and this is upward, take negative. So WE L by 2 minus WX. Then the shear force at section XX is equal to WE bracket L by 2 minus X. So this is the analysis of 3-inch stiffening girder due to the uniform distributed load. And due to the external loading, you know that you have to find out by taking the moment about one end, you can find out what is the reaction at the other end. Similarly, by taking the moment at the other end, you will get what is the reaction of the other end. So this way you can find out the reaction. Then after getting the reaction, then you can find out what is the bending moment and what is shear force at any point in the stiffening girder. this is the analysis of the three stepping order. Then you have to do the analysis of the suspension cable due to the uniformly distributed load. So what is the uniformly distributed load is acting on the suspension cable? So by considering this UDL, so you have to do the analysis of this suspension cable. So what already we have discussed in previous class, that the cable subjected to UDL. So what is the vertical reaction? VB is equal to WL by 2. Already we have discussed this, and we have derived these relations. And what is the horizontal thrust? Horizontal thrust is equal to WL square by 8H. Then what is the maximum tension? Tmax. Tmax is equal to this is root over of H square plus V square. But you know H is equal to WL square by 8H and V is equal to WL by 2. WL by 2 whole square plus WL square by 8H whole square is equal to WL by 2 root over of 1 plus L square by 16 H square. Then you know what is the slope with the horizontal. Theta is equal to cos inverse H by T max. And also you know the deflection of the cable. You know the deflection of the cable y. Y is equal to 4hx into l minus x divided by l square. And you know the length of the cable, capital L is equal to small l plus 8h square by 3l. This is capital L. The length of the cable is your capital L. And small l is the distance between the two support. So capital L is equal to small l plus 8h square by 3l. This is the length of the cable. Where L is the horizontal distance between two supports, W is uniform distributed load per unit length, and H is the central dip of the cable. This is central dip of the cable. Already we have discussed the analysis of the cable in previous classes. Then coming to one problem, a 3-inch depending girder of a suspension bridge of span 100 meter is subjected to two point loads of 200 kilonewton and 300 kilonewton at the distance of 25 meter and 50 meter from the left end. Find the shear force and bending moment for the girder at a distance 30 meter from the left end. The supporting cable has a central dip of 10 meter. Find also the maximum tension and its slope in the cable. So here you see, so this is the cable, suspension cable, and this is the stiffening girder, 3-inch stiffening girder. So here given two point loads. Here given two point loads on the stiffening girder at a distance 25 meter from the support and 50 meter from the support. 200 kilonewton load is acting at a distance 25 meter from the support, and 300 kilonewton load is acting at a distance of 50 meter from the support A. And this is the uniform distributed load. This is due to the suspender. The distance between two support is given. This is 100 meter, and the central dip is given 10 meter. This is the data given. So here you have to find out what is the shear force and bending moment for the girder at a distance 30 meter from the left end. So here at a distance 30 meter from the left end, you have to find out what is the shear force and bending moment on the girder. And also you have to find out what is the maximum tension in the cable and what is the slope of the cable with the horizontal. You have to find out what is the maximum tension in the cable. Where you will get the maximum tension? At the support. So here you have to find out what is the maximum tension in the cable and what is the slope of the cable with the horizontal. Here, so you have to do the analysis of this one in two parts. So first you have to do the analysis of the 3-inch stiffening girder, then you have to do the analysis of the suspension cable. Here you have to find out what is the UDL is your present, what is the UDL is your acting on the 3-inch stiffening girder, that you have to find out. And you have to find out what is the reactions due to the external loading and you have to find out what is the shear force and bending moment at a distance 30 meter from the support. This you have to find out in the 3-inch deepening girder. But in the analysis of the suspension cable, you have to find out what is the maximum tension in the cable and what is the angle with the horizontal. That you have to find out. So first, coming to the analysis of stiffening girder. So first, to find out what is the reaction due to external load. So what is the external load you are acting here? So this is 200 kilonewton is acting at a distance 25 meter from the support, and 300 kilonewton is acting at a distance 50 meter from the support. So due to these two load, what is the reaction at both end of the stiffening girder? That you have to find out. Let the suspenders exert a uniformly distributed load W per unit horizontal length as shown in figure 3. Reaction at A and B due to given loading only be denoted as RA dash and RB dash respectively. So due to this loading, so what is the reaction at the end A dash and what is the reaction at the end B dash? So at A dash you have to take RA dash and at the end B dash you have to take RB dash. So first to take for the reaction in the girder, take summation of MA dash is equal to 0. So here you take the summation of moment at the end A is equal to 0. This is for the external loading. So this is two load you are present, 200 into 25, and this is 300 into 50, 225, 350. And due to this reaction, RB dash into 100. So RB dash into 100 minus 200 into 25, minus 300 into 50 is equal to 0. Then RB dash is equal to 200 kilonewton. Then find out the another reaction, RB dash, then RA dash. Then find out the reaction RA dash by taking the summation of vertical force is equal to 0. Only this is for the external loading. The reaction due to the external loading, this is RA dash. Reaction due to external loading, this is RB dash. RA dash plus RB dash is equal to 200 plus 300. RA dash is here equal to 300 kilonewton. So this is the reaction. So here you got the reaction RA dash and RB dash due to the external loading. Here you see, this is the analysis of the 3-inch deepening girder, and this is the analysis of the suspension cable. So here you got RA dash is here equal to 300 kilonewton. And RB dash is equal to, you got 200 kilonewton, and this is only due to the external loading. What is the uniform distributed load is exerted by the suspender on the 3-inch deepening girder and on the cable? That you have to find out here. So how you will find out this one? Because you see, in the case of 3-inch deepening girder, the moment at the hinge is equal to 0. The moment at the third hinge, which is present at the center, this is your equal to 0. So the moment at the C point is equal to 0. MC dash is equal to 0. So from this consideration, so you can find out what is the external load is acting on the 3-inch deepening girder. Suspender uniform distributed load. You have to find out here what is the uniform distributed load is exerted by the suspender on the 3-inch deepening girder. So what you have to do? So you have to take the moment at the central hinge of the girder is 0. Summation of MC dash is equal to 0. Because here this is the stiffening girder. So in the stiffening girder, so this is the force due to the external loading. This is the external loading and this is the reaction. And this is the UDL present. This is due to the suspender. And this is the reaction due to the UDL. This is the reaction due to the UDL. So you have to take the bending moment due to given loading plus bending moment due to the uniform distributed load which is acting on the 3-inch deepening girder. So you don't know this one. You don't know what is the value of WE. So that you have to find out. So here you have to take the moment at the central edge of the girder is 0. Summation of MC dash is equal to 0. But you have to take the bending moment, that is due to the given loading and due to the uniform distributed load. So both moment is equal to 0. So you know here you have to take the moment, because here you see this is the reaction. So you have to take the moment at the point C dash is equal to zero, MC dash is equal to zero. So due to this reaction, what is the moment here? RB dash into L by 2. L by 2 is equal to 50 meter. So RB dash into L by 2. RB dash into L by 2. And this is the anticlockwise moment. This is anticlockwise moment. And due to this UTL, due to this UTL, what is the moment at the center? What is the moment at the center? So already we got in theory. So this is the moment. So this is the moment. So maximum bending moment due to uniform distributed load, the maximum bending moment at C is equal to WE L square by 8. This is a Hawking moment. This is minus WE L square by 8. The maximum bending moment at C due to uniform distributed load is equal to minus WE L square by 8. So directly you take this one. RB dash into L by 2 minus WE L square by 8 is equal to 0. So this is the bending moment due to the uniform distributed load, and this is the bending moment due to the external loading. So, and here this is due to this one, this is negative due to this UTL Hawking moment. So you have to take this is your minus WE L square by 8, and due to this one, this is your anticlockwise direction, this is you take positive RB dash into L by 2. Minus WE L square by 8 is equal to 0. Then after simplification, so here you will get the uniform distributed load WE is equal to 8 kilonewton divided by meter. So this is the UTL. So here you got from this condition, that is the moment of the central hinge of the girder is equal to 0. Then find out what is the shear force and bending moment at a distance 30 meter from the support edge. So here you have to find out what is the bending moment and what is the shear force. These are the loading. So this is the UTL and reaction due to the UTL. And this is the external loading. And this is the reaction due to the external loading. And you have to find out what is the bending moment and shear force at a distance 30 meter from the support edge. Here you have to find out. To consider here the left side of the section. What are the forces acting on left side of the section? So here this is the reaction, and this is the load is acting, and this is the UTL is your acting upward, and this is the reaction due to UTL, this is acting downward. These are the forces acting. So first you find out shear force. Shear force at a distance 30 meter from the support edge. So shear force that you have to find out, shear force due to given loading plus shear force due to WE. So due to given loading, this is the given loading, and reaction due to given loading, this one, and due to UTL, this is the force, and the reaction due to the UTL, this is the force. So you have to take the sum of the force at the section axis. So Fx is your shear force is your equal to RA dash, this is your left side upward, RA dash positive minus 200. Downward direction, this is downward direction, negative. You are considering here the left side of the section. So left side of section, so the upward force you take positive and downward force you take negative. So RA dash positive 300 and the loading 200, this is you take negative 300 minus 200. 300 minus 200. Then due to this loading, due to this UTL, this is upward. So what is the load here? So here you got the load is at 8 kilonewton by meter. And what is the distance? Here you take, this is your 30 meter. So 8 into 30. This is, and this one, this is your acting downward direction. So due to this direction, this is your take negative. So this is your 8 into L by 2. This is your 50 meter. 8 into 50. This is downward. So here shear force is equal to RADS minus 200 minus WE 100 by 2 minus 30. Shear force is equal to 300 minus 200 minus 8, 50 minus 30. So the shear force is equal to minus 60 kilonewton. So here you got the negative value. So means the shear force direction is your upward direction. The shear force is your upward at a distance 30 meter from the support ADS. This is the shear force. Then find out what is the bending moment. So here also you have to take the bending moment due to given loading and bending moment due to the uniform distributed load. So you know that is the, here you have to find out the bending moment due to the given loading. So this is the reaction. So due to this reaction and due to this load, and here also due to this UDL, and this is the reaction due to UDL. This is the reaction for UDL. So due to this, so you have to take moment here, RA dash into 30, because RA dash is your equal to 300 into 30, then minus 200 into 5, minus WEX by 2 into L minus X. Already here we've got this one, minus WEX by 2 into L minus X. This is the bending moment at section XX. So minus WX by 2 into L minus X. So the bending moment is equal to 300 into 30 minus 200 into 5 minus 8 into 30 divided by 2 into 100 minus 30 is equal to minus 400 kilonewton meter. So this is the bending moment at a distance 30 meter from the support A'. The bending moment is equal to 400 kilonewton meter again, at a distance 30 meter from the support A'. This is, so here, you got what is the shear force and what is the bending moment. So this is all about the analysis of the 3-inch stiffening girder. Then coming to the analysis of cable. So you know already we have discussed in the previous classes that how to find out the reaction at the supports. So the vertical reaction at A and B is equal to VA is equal to VB is equal to WEL by 2. You know here WE is equal to, this is 8 kilonewton by meter, 8 into 100 by 2, this is equal to 400 kilonewton. The reaction at A and B is equal to 400 kilonewton. This is, reaction at A is your 400 kilonewton and reaction at B is also 400 kilonewton. Then find out the horizontal thrust H. You know how to find out this horizontal thrust. For getting horizontal reaction or thrust, taking moment about C. So here you have to take the moment of this one, original thrust and vertical reaction and UDL, and UDL. For this UDL, vertical reaction and original thrust, you have to take moment about the point C. So this is equal to H into H. This is due to the original thrust and this is due to the vertical reaction, WL by 2 into L by 2. And this is due to the UDL minus WE into L by 2 into L by 4. This is H into H is equal to WL by 2 into L by 2 minus WE into L by 2 into L by 4 is equal to WE L square by 8. Then H is equal to WE L square by 8 H, 8 small h. Then you can find out what is the value of H, original thrust. W is equal to 8 and L is equal to 100, 8 and H is equal to, small h is equal to 10. Then from this you can find out the original thrust is here equal to 1000 kilonewton. You can directly also find out using this relation. Using this relation also you can find out directly. So H is equal to W L square by 8H. Horizontal thrust. H is equal to WL square by 8 small h. So this is equal to 10,000 kilonewton. Then H is equal to 1,000 kilonewton. Then find out what is the maximum tension and the slope. Find out what is the maximum tension and slope. You know what is the formula for maximum tension? T max is equal to root over of VA square plus H square. But here you got VA is equal to 400 kilonewton and H is equal to 1000 kilonewton. So T max is equal to root over of 400 square plus 1000 square is equal to 1077.033 kilonewton. So this is the maximum tension in the cable. then find out the slope of the cable with the horizontal. Find out the slope of the cable with the horizontal. So this is, you see, already in, we have discussed in last class. T max cos theta is equal to h, theta is equal to cos inverse h by T max. So theta is equal to cos inverse, h is equal to 1000, and here you got T max is equal to 1077.033 kilonewton. And theta is equal to cos inverse 1000 by 1077.033 is equal to 21.80 degree. So this is the slope of the cable with the horizontal, and this is the maximum tension in the cable. Now you are clear that how to do the analysis of suspension bridge with 3-inch stiffening girder.